In this class, we are going to see how it works when we want to save, publish and share our app. Here in the top right menu, in the actions of the app, we can click on the button save that's close of the play button that we just saw a couple of classes ago, and this will save the app. It's very important to do this in the very beginning once you create, so you don't lose what you have created and then it starts saving automatically. Every 2 minutes, the app will save automatically and you won't lose it anymore. But save for the first time to guarantee. Okay, now, once the app saved, we want to publish the customizations, we just click on this button here, the publish button. So we are going to click, we can provide a description of the app, what we are doing at this point. So for example, we could put here, added a rounded button, and then we just click in the publish this version. This will publish and make it available for the users that have access to the app. Now if I do any changes and I don't publish, they won't see these new changes until I publish. So you can publish the stable version and keep doing your changes if necessary to do some adjustments, and then publish again and the users will see the new updates. How can someone have access to the app? Okay, you by default will have the access if you go to make.powerapps.com, and you should be able to see your app here in the apps part of the interface. Here I can order, let's see. Here I can see that in the modified 1 minute ago I have my app 001. So I can click and it will play the app as a user would use the app. So here it's in the play mode because I just clicked on the app. So I can just interact with this button. It doesn't do anything because I didn't put any action. But here is the app I just played. Let's try now going to screen one where we have that button and adding a new element here. Let's add a rectangle here. So I'm going to go to insert and add the rectangle and I'm going to save. We can see that nothing happens. If I refresh this tab, the rectangle doesn't show here because I didn't publish yet. So now let's publish and see what happens. I'm going to publish and let me type here, added the rectangle to the first screen. And I'm going to click on publish this version. Now it's published. If I go back to that tab or play the app again, clicking here or clicking on play, it will load and show me that a new version is coming. So it takes a couple of seconds for the new version to come. Once the new version is ready, it will show a button here to refresh. It just showed. It shows the warning saying I'm using an old version. This is very new. Power Apps didn't have this a couple of months ago. And is very useful. This video is sponsored by the support of my subscribers who like and comment on the videos. This class is part of a full course I have on Udemy where I teach beginners how to build their first apps. So if you want to ensure lifetime access and see the entire course, I suggest you to join me on Udemy. If the course isn't for you, that's okay. But I kindly ask you to show your support by liking this video and subscribe to this channel. Your engagement means a lot to me and motivates me to continue creating valuable content like this. So I can click here and refresh. The app will reload. Let me just refresh again. Sometimes it takes a while, a couple of refreshes. And here is the new rectangle I just inserted and published. Okay. Since I'm the owner of this app, I can see the app here, but if it were another user, they wouldn't see until you share the app with the user. One way to share is here in the make.powerapps.com with the app selected, you can click on share, and it will open this pop-up to share with the users, but you can also share here while you're developing the app, if I click here on share in the action bar. So if I click here, it will go to that very same screen and show the very same pop-up. Here I can type the user email that I want to share. For example, Bruce, I want to share with Bruce Wayne. And then I can select if this user is a co-owner, meaning if the user can also edit the app or not. If I don't select, the user is just a user, a normal user, and he cannot edit this app, just play it. I can also type something in the message and add an image that will be sent to his email, and he will be able to see the link for the app. Here I have the option to mark if I want to send the email or not. So once I click share, the users you share the app will receive the email with the link to play the app. If it's a very complex app where the whole company or the whole department use it, there are other ways to share that's using security groups. It's more advanced, and you may search about that or talk with your IT department and understand this better. But right now we are just going to share with the users here directly. Okay, so I click on share, and an email will be sent to the user I just shared. Now the user can go and open and click on the link to access the app. In the next lesson, we are going to see how we can restore a previous version. So for example, imagine I just added this rectangle and I don't want it. I want to reverse to the previous version. So I'm going to show you where you can find the versions you published and revert to that version. So see you in the next class.